name is Ajay Babar, and I'm working as a junior software engineer and working on a project Proxymity, which is under the supervision of Professor D.B. Fatak. Before going into detailed explanation of what is Proximity, first I am going to tell you the meaning for Proximity. Proximity means near to the real things. For example, suppose if anyone like a student or a professor missed some lecture or could not attend or could not able to attend the lecture and wants to attend or wants to watch that lecture, in that case, the Proximity software will help us. So, what is the Proximity? The Proximity is an open source multimedia integration software tool built using the Java Swing and VLCJ. That's why it's open source and it is also a platform independent. Now, we have used the open source languages like Java Swing, as you are familiar with it, and another is the VLCJ. It's a Java binding which allows the instance of VLC media player to be embedded into our Java AWT window or Java Swing JFrame. And using the VLCJ, we can implement our own functionality like play, pause, stop, seek to, jump to the particular time. And therefore, we have used the VLC because it's an open source and it plays almost all the video formats like WMV, AVI, or MKV, MPEG, MP4, and therefore the Proximity becomes an platform independent and an open source software. Now, Proximity helps us to create a dynamic and rich multimedia lectures using the multimedia data. Now, what are the multimedia data? The multimedia data comprises the audio, images, text, or video. These are all the multimedia data. And therefore, the Proximity enables the user to create rich multimedia presentation slides or the multimedia lecture presentation in which we bind the main video with its related presentation slides. Now, what can I do with the Proximity? As I said, Proximity is an open source and platform independent. We can install and run the Proximity on a computer that is running either the Microsoft XP, Windows 7, or Ubuntu. In Proximity, there are two modes, I think. Yeah, there are two modes in which the administrator imports the main video. Then he imports the slides, and then administrator binds that video with the slide with a respective timeline. In that Proximity, we can add lecture video, lecture slides, and still images. This software allow all the video formats, as I said, that WMV, AVI, FLV, and MPEG. Finally, by using this software, it finally publishes the synchronized multimedia lecture presentation ready to be used for e-learning, so that the student can watch the entire multimedia lecture with all the bindings of main video and its related presentation slides. And this final product is a rich multimedia lecture presentation released under the Creative Commons by Attribution 2.5. And we can distribute this published lecture either through the pen drive, that is the portable storage devices, and student can watch it anytime and anywhere.
So whatever Ajay told, it's already been done. The desktop publish has already been done. Our team has done it. So let me more elaborate about this desktop publish window, more technical terms. You may be wondering how the datas have come. The datas like speaker name, phone number, the tree view, etc. are coming from XML file. It's already been stored in an XML file. And for creating that XML file, and another edit window has been made for that the XML file gets created. These two windows are having VLC player, that is also a player, and this is also a player. It can play static slides as well as video files also. So now we are concentrating on whether it's a desktop versus web published. Desktop, as I told, is already being published. Web published, we are going to do in the 1 month period. So what are the advantage of desktop published? The technologies used which were in the desktop published were Java Swing, VLC Player, VLCJ, Java Bindings. These technologies were used so that it runs in all the PC, in all the web in all the platform oriented, whether it is Ubuntu or XP or Windows 7. And the main advantage is that those who are not having any internet connection, they can view as a desktop application. So it means that we don't need an internet connection for it. And the third point is that it can be distributed to portable devices such as DVD, pen drives, etc. So we need to physically carry that jar file as well as the images in a DVD and pen drive. This is a web published, which are we going to use in this 1 month. The technologies which we have shortlisted are HTML5, JavaScript, JavaFX 2.1, and JW Player. The main purpose of web publish is that it can be run in a web browser. The players are going to be embedded in the web browser. And as a desktop publish needs physically to be that videos as well as slides to be stored, but the one time we will be needed to store the in the server, like the slides as well as the lecture videos. But the main part is that we need a internet connection, and that to a broadband connection. And what I need is that in this 1 month we should deploy the desktop application to a web application. The output would be almost like this. In fact, it should be better than this, as is the web published. So as an input, you will be given an XML file, and after that, you have to embed these players into that web page. Okay, thank you. Thank you.